I'm Bruce Bugbee, and this is an introduction to a 7-lecture series on the principles of energy balance in environmental systems. So in this overview, I'm going to go through what each of the lectures discusses to give you the opportunity to skip to certain lectures and go back and review specific things so you know exactly what's in each of the 7 lectures. So here's the first lecture. It's got a detailed outline. In that lecture, I give an introduction to water use in agriculture. Water in agriculture uses at least 70% of the water in the nation, and where does all that water go? That's the huge criteria here. And then secondly, how do we exactly measure how much of that water is used by agriculture? The answer is we use principles of energy balance. So this tells the challenge of this whole thing and the importance of it. I review several reference books on this. One of them we use as a textbook for this class. Then we get into this first law of thermodynamics and the 7 components, latent heat of evaporation, understanding energy and power, this is joules and watts, and finally short and long wave radiation. And then we give you homework, and the first homework is E equals MC squared homework. That's lecture 1, to let you go quickly to that and see what's in there. Now, let's take a look at lecture 2. Talked about the key for the homework, how to calculate the energy in a pea seed. Units of conversions, capital C for calories, lowercase. Then we calculate the efficiency of photosynthesis and show that this is really so small we can ignore it in these principles. Finally, absorbed shortwave radiation and the importance of albedo, the 3 component parts of shortwave radiation, UV, photosynthetic, and near infrared. Definitions. What is shortwave? What's longwave? And then we introduce the Stefan-Boltzmann law for shortwave radiation. That's the end of lecture 2. Lecture 3 gets us into the concept of emissivity. Let's see if I can center these right there. Concept of emissivity, this is about long wave radiation. Calculating long wave emitted, net long wave, and then finally bringing all the radiation together in lecture 3, net absorbed short wave and net absorbed long wave. So this is the end of the principles in the 3 lectures. Then we open lecture 4. Applying energy balance principles to the planet Earth. And this also gets into is the energy balanced perfectly on the Earth, or is the Earth slightly warming? And this really helps you understand the challenge of accurately measuring small amounts of global warming. And the best minds in the planet are working on this now. Then we get into differential absorption of short and long wave radiation. Not all the wavelengths are the same. Reflectance of long wave radiation, a tiny bit is reflected, and then 2 critical equations that apply to these types of radiation. One is Wien's law, and the second one is Planck's law. That's the end of the 4th lecture. Lecture 5, we focus on transpiration. Now we have net radiation in here. The whole lecture is all on how we calculate transpiration, which is the flux of water, and transpiration is determined by the driving gradient for transpiration, for evaporation, divided by the resistance to flow of these water molecules out into the atmosphere. We discuss absolute and relative humidity. That's critical to understanding those two. The flux, calculating the driving gradient, determining stomatal conductance, and finally modeling it. That's all in lecture 5. Lecture 6, I'll move it up just a bit. Conduction and convection, the next big component part of this. Hot air blowing away, hot surfaces blowing away to cold surfaces. That's driven by boundary layer resistance or boundary layer conductance. And so how do we measure that and how do we model the movement heat by conduction and convection? These components then compromise the whole energy balance equation and the component parts. And in the end, the goal is to calculate the movement of water through the system. Lecture 7, the last and final lecture, is a summary and application of the principles. So we look at water movement in the day, but what happens at night? Now the sun sets and all of the surfaces get colder than the air temperature. On a clear night, they radiate to the sky and we get radiation frost. Things freeze even when the air temperature is not freezing. We go through those. And then finally, a summary of how do these principles apply to the very famous Penman-Monteith equation, and how do we use that to model transpiration rates? And then finally, the much simpler Hargreaves equation, which is elegant in its simplicity and almost as accurate as the Penman-Monteith. So this is a summary lecture of all the principles of energy balance. So with this introduction, you can skip around to the lectures and look at the ones that you are most interested in. They generally build on each other, but it's not required that you go through an order because we expect all the viewers are going to have different backgrounds and certain component parts are going to be more important than others. Thanks for listening and let the lectures begin.